Many Australian cricket selectors have gone for Mitchell Starc over Mitchell Johnson for the first test against Sri Lanka starting tomorrow. 22-year-old Starc gets the nod despite Johnson's 6-wicket haul against South Africa at the Wacker.
He is unlucky to miss out, but it's, you know, we've gone for this attack for this test match in these conditions against the opposition we're playing.
Peter Siddle and Ben Helfenhaus join Starc in a three-pronged pace attack. Mike Hussey trained today after missing yesterday with a head cold, so that is good news. Now to the Big Bash, and the Brisbane Heat have beaten the Adelaide Strikers in a nail-biter. The Strikers made 185 from their 20 overs. Callum Ferguson top scored with 52, and big West Indian Kyron Pollard sent quite a few balls into the construction site, hitting 48 off 20. In reply, the Heat's Luke Pommer's back belted 65 off 39 balls, the left-hander clearing the Adelaide Oval fence with ease.
That is massive. What a good catch by the punter in the crowd. And he's sculling at the same time. Jeez.
That is a skill. A great catch too. And so was this effort from Tim Ludeman, diving full stretch to his left. However, it wasn't enough, with Chris Hartley hitting a boundary off the last ball to win the match in dramatic circumstances. Well played. The biggest draw card at the Australian PGA lasted just two holes this morning, with Greg Norman forced to withdraw after suffering a bout of food poisoning. Victorian Daniel Popovich is the outright leader after an opening round 8-under-64. Jeff Ogilvy isn't too far behind after some pretty handy work around the greens. Clearly the locals weren't happy. Norman had to pull out. Ogilvy produced his second eagle of the day on the 12th.
Jeff Ogilvy!
26-year-old Popovich produced the round of his life, his brilliance matched by his courage, revealing afterwards his father was earlier this year diagnosed with incurable cancer. Now, as you may have seen earlier, the tax office has applied for Nathan Tinkler's teams, the Newcastle Knights and Jets, to be wound up due to unpaid debts of more than $2.5 million. Tinkler's Hunter Sports Group was unaware of the ATO's action until informed by the media.
I've been advised that the outstanding payment to the ATO will be paid shortly and this issue will be resolved.
The NRL says if Tinkler goes bankrupt, the Knights will be safe, with ownership reverting back to the members with a $20 million bank guarantee. AFL now in Hawthorn is bucking the trend, opting for the Sunshine Coast for a pre-season camp rather than overseas high-altitude training. With surfboards in tow, some new-look Hawks flew out for Queensland today. The players more than happy to be staying down under for the pre-season.
Those boys got 20-hour flights and we've only got 2 hours to the Gold Coast, so it's, different clubs got their different ways of training and worked well for us last year and we'll go out there and do it again this year.
Hawthorn will spend 7 days up north on the training camp before breaking for Christmas. Alessandro Del Piero is racing the clock to be fit for Saturday's Sydney Derby against the Wanderers. The marquee man hasn't been sighted at training all week, plagued by a hamstring problem.
There's still that little bit of doubt there, so, you know, we've still got 48 hours, so we'll wait and see.
And Melbourne Victory striker Archie Thompson admits he's struggling to recover in time for Saturday's match against Brisbane Roar after a taxing trip to Hong Kong with the Socceroos. Today's play of the day is a battle between man and beast. The Blade Runner, Oscar Pistorius, pitted against a horse named Maserati over 200 metres in Doha. With a 15-metre head start, Oscar annihilated his opponent, but he was chasing a bigger win.
Hope that'll do a lot to change the perceptions of people with disabilities in this region.
Oscar made history this year by competing with able-bodied athletes at the London Olympics and for proving he's faster than a Maserati. The Blade Runner bags our player of the day. Good idea.
Well deserved. Done. Wow.
Yeah, what an inspirational
chap. What a superhuman.
Mm. He is.